Richwood, Ohio. Richwood is a village in Union County, Ohio, United States. The population was 2,229 at the 2010 census. Union County was organized on January 10, 1820 from territory previously contained in Franklin, Madison, Logan, and Delaware Counties. Claiborne Township was surveyed by Richard Claiborne in 1811, and at that time the land was mostly level with some light rolling. He describes the soil as argillaceous with a thick tree growth. The first settler in Claiborne Township was Cyprian Lee, who with Henry Swartz took the contract to build the township's first road in 1825. The 15-foot-wide road was cut from the southernmost to the northernmost lines of the township, the effort consisting of clearing underbrush and small trees, leaving many obstacles in the shape of large timber. This north-to-south road passed through what would become Richwood. In 1832, two land grants of 1,200 acres each in Union County were received by William Pelham and Charles Blagrove of Virginia. Mr. Pelham sold his land to Charles Blagrove that same year, and he promptly gave his land to his two nieces, Catherine and Parthenia Blagrove of Washington, D.C., splitting the grant in half. Parthenia received 1,200 acres on which a portion of Richwood would later stand. Miss Blagrove put her legal affairs in the hands of Delaware attorney George Bomford, who sold the land to Philip Plummer. Philip Plummer was originally from Mount Vernon, but he had been impressed with Union County's tree growth and rich soil. Once he had purchased Miss Blagrove's plat, he returned with his brother Thomas, who was a surveyor. Together they found that the level ground and distance from Marysville, the county seat, would make that location desirable for a city. The town of Richwood was laid out in the summer of 1832 by Philip, his brother Thomas, and Union County surveyor Levi Phelps, who aided the project with interested and able support and whose office recorded the first boundary lines for the new town. When the surveying was finished, Richwood was platted and declared open for settlement, the plat covering a total area of 44 acres. The north, south, and east-west roads were named Franklin, after Benjamin Franklin, and Ottaway, later renamed Ottawa, respectively, both to be 100 feet wide. Four other streets were platted: Fulton and Clinton streets going north-south, Blagrove and Bomford going east-west, each to be 82.5 feet wide. Plummer donated some lots for public property to be used for specific purposes under specific conditions. Lots 13 and 60 on Franklin Street were to be the first and second fire companies, though they had to comprise 50 or more persons each and own either an engine and hose or buckets and ladders. Lot 44 was to be a public library, which had to have a board of trustees and 200 volumes of useful and miscellaneous publications. Apostrophe. Lot 100 was to be a museum, lots 117 and 118 for mayor or town council, lots 137 and 138 for a marketplace, lots 122, 123, 142 and 143 for common schools, outlot 5 for a church, and outlot 14 for a botanical garden. The year before Richwood was incorporated, Ohio State Legislature passed an act that returned ownership of these lots to Philip Plummer and his heirs. The first building in Richwood was a one-room log cabin on the north side of Ottawa Street occupied by Dr. John P. Brookins and his family. Dr. Brookins was a friend of Philip's from Mount Vernon and had been looking for a place to practice his medicine. For many years, he was the only doctor in Richwood and served as justice of the peace and as postmaster. The cabin had one door, two windows, a puncheon floor, clapboard roof, and a scutched, smoothed interior. The first death in Richwood was Dr. Brookins' daughter Mary Jane, who died of severe burns when her clothes caught fire. Two versions of the story exist, one being that she had been sitting too close to the hearth, and the other being that she got too close to a log burning. His family also saw the town's first haunting. The second cabin in Richwood was built by blacksmith Absalom Carney on the corner of East Bomford and Franklin Streets. His cabin had two rooms, the larger of which was for his blacksmithing shop. He mainly sharpened tools and shoot horses. Shoemaker John T. Evans of Dayton was the person who built the third cabin near the center of town, using timber on his property to make shoemaker lasts for boots and shoes that he sold at market in nearby communities. He was a well-liked individual, and as a result his shop became a popular gathering place. In 1834 Richwood got its first established business, a grocery store opened by Burdick and Calloway. That same year the Methodist Episcopal Church in town formed a meeting society. Several more families moved to Richwood from 1833 to 1934, some being William Phillips, a teacher who brought his family of eight children, John Wood, a tailor, John Wilson, a carpenter, Christian Gould, a shoemaker that stayed but a year, Nathan Richardson, a carpenter, Adam Burge, a Thomsonian doctor who lived on Lot 105 and left in short time, William Price, John T. Evans, who made shoes and boots, was benched in Burdick and Calloway's store and left of Terrier, and Henry Sayer, who began building a cabin on Franklin Street but moved west before it was completed. Thomas Plummer, the principal surveyor, had platted Richwood, built a residence at 17 Franklin Street. After he left Richwood, the Plummer house was used for lodging. In 1834, road work was completed, and all the roads going into the town were graveled. The Methodist Episcopal Church was formally organized on October 17, 1835 by Reverend William Frizzell, who served as an itinerant minister. William Phillips served as the first class leader. He was elected as the first steward of the Richwood Circuit. The first church building was a hewn log cabin with a plowed and grooved floor. In 1840, 25 families were listed as living in Richwood. In March 1835, Richwood was incorporated as a village. As of 1877, the town contained one newspaper, two banks, three churches, one brick schoolhouse, and several stores and factories. Richwood is home to several businesses. One of the oldest businesses is Richwood Bank. In May 1876, the Bank of Richwood was established at 116 North Franklin Street. Then, in 1906, the bank was incorporated with $35,000 and made its first name change to the Richwood Banking Company. In this year, the newly renamed bank also found a new location at the corner of North Franklin and East Blagrove, where it sits today. Before the Great Depression, there were three banks in Richwood. They included the Farmers Deposit Bank, the First National Bank of Richwood, and the Richwood Banking Company. The Great Depression brought on many struggles for the banking industry, and the Richwood Banking Company was the only bank in Richwood to survive. In the 1970s, the company started to expand beyond Richwood. In 1976, the bank's capital was $300,000, surplus was $800,000, and total assets amounted to $18 million. 2017 marks the celebration of Richwood Bank's 150th anniversary. Today, the bank has branches in Richwood, LaRue, Marysville, Huntsville, Plain City, and Delaware. They now operate several divisions, including Richwood Marketing, Richwood Coffee, and Richwood Payroll. 2017 marks the celebration of Richwood Bank's 150th anniversary. Richwood is located at 40.426927-83.297404. According to the United States Census Bureau, the village has a total area of which is land and is water. Richwood is at the junction of State Highways 37 and 47. As of the census of 2010, there were 2,229 people, 877 households, and 572 families residing in the village. The population density was: there were 969 housing units at an average density of. The racial makeup of the village was 98.3% white, 0.4% African American, 0.2% Native American, 0.1% from other races, and 0.9% from two or more races. Hispanic or Latino of any race were 0.7% of the population. There were 877 households, of which 40.6% had children under the age of 18 living with them, 45.7% were married couples living together, 13.3% had a female householder with no husband present, 6.2% had a male householder with no wife present, and 34.8% were non-families. 29.6% of all households were made up of individuals, and 14.1% had someone living alone who was 65 years of age or older. The average household size was 2.54 and the average family size was 3.14. The median age in the village was 34.2 years. 29.6% of residents were under the age of 18, 7.5% were between the ages of 18 and 24, 28.2% were from 25 to 44. 22% were from 45 to 64, and 12.7% were 65 years of age or older. The gender makeup of the village was 47.4% male and 52.6% female. As of the census of 2000, there were 2,156 people, 849 households, and 567 families residing in the village. The population density was 1,795.2 people per square mile, 693.7 per square kilometer. There were 957 housing units at an average density of 796.9 per square mile, 307.9 per square kilometer. The racial makeup of the village was 97.96% white, 0.23% African American, 0.14% Native American, 0.09% Asian, 0.19% from other races, and 1.39% from two or more races. Hispanic or Latino of any race were 0.32% of the population. There were 849 households, out of which 35.8% had children under the age of 18 living with them, 52.5% were married couples living together, 11.0% had a female householder with no husband present, and 33.1% were non-families. 28.2% of all households were made up of individuals and 15.8% had someone living alone who was 65 years of age or older. The average household size was 2.54 and the average family size was 3.12. In the village, the population was spread out with 29.3% under the age of 18, 7.9% from 18 to 24, 29.3% from 25 to 44, 19.4% from 45 to 64, and 14.1% who were 65 years of age or older. The median age was 33 years. For every 100 females there were 90.1 males. For every 100 females age 18 and over, there were 87.6 males. The median income for a household in the village was $39,550, and the median income for a family was $47,656. Males had a median income of $33,393 versus $21,971 for females. The per capita income for the village was $16,799. About 6.6% of families and 8.4% of the population were below the poverty line, including 9.0% of those under age 18 and 12.7% of those age 65 or over. Richwood is the home of the North Union Local School District. The North Union High School football team is known as the Wildcats. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.